Today's scripture reading is found in the second epistle to Timothy, chapter 1, and I shall read verses 3 to 5. This is the Apostle Paul writing to his spiritual son and protege, Timothy. He says, "I constantly remember you in my prayers, recalling your tears. I long to see you so that I may be filled with joy. I've been reminded also of your sincere faith." Tomorrow is Memorial Day, and I want to ask you, what does this day mean to you? Does it mean an extra day of work? Does it only mean a long weekend, a three-day weekend? Does it mean a barbecue cookout or a family picnic at the beach? Memorial Day, as its name tells us, is a day set aside to remember. To remember those who make the ultimate sacrifice, those who sacrifice their lives to ensure that we live in freedom and enjoy liberty. On this day, we also remember our parents, our relatives, our friends, our loved ones, who before departing from this world, somehow, in their own peculiar way, contributed to our well-being. We also remember in a special way our spiritual mentors, those who led us to faith. It's good to remember people, to love people, to think of them. In today's scripture reading, we discovered how the Apostle Paul remembered his young friend Timothy. He remembered him in several ways. He remembered to pray for him. He says, "I pray for you constantly." Number two, he remembered Timothy's pain. He says, "I recall your tears." And third, the Apostle Paul remembered that Timothy was a man who had sincere faith. Someone has said, "Say goodbye to me, but not to the thought of me." Bedros Turian, an Armenian romantic poet who was very talented, but unfortunately died when he was just 25 years old. He died of tuberculosis, which was not treatable in those days. Now he says, "I die when people stop reading my books and no longer remember me." Yes, we remember the veterans, our parents, our friends, our relatives, our spiritual mentors who contributed to our spiritual and overall well-being. Thomas Monaghan was the founder and first president of Domino's Pizza. From 1970 to 1985, he was able to grow Domino's Pizza from a debt-ridden small company to the second largest pizza company in the United States. How was he able to accomplish this? How, within 15 years, he was able to take a debt rhythm small company and grow it to become the second largest pizza company in the United States. So newsmen were interested in interviewing him, and one day when he was asked how he was able to account for this phenomenal growth, he replied, "The key of our success is not in the cheese we use, is not in the tasty crust of our pizza, is not in our fast delivery schedules. The key of our success lies in developing our employees." He said, special interest in every one of our employees and tried to provide opportunities for them to refine their skills. That led to success. Yes, we should not only remember people, but also consider people to be our most important assets. Invest in people, not in things. God is interested in people, and He loves people, and He wants them to be saved. God doesn't wish that anyone be lost. His desire is that everyone be saved. But we know not everyone will be saved, because some people will choose of their own free will to spurn God's love, disregard His grace, and not accept the truth of the gospel. Every one of us is given the opportunity of either accepting or rejecting the truth of the gospel. We have to realize that certain things in life are more important. Rick Warren, who is the pastor of Saddleback Church, one of the largest churches in Orange County, and he's the author of The Purpose-Driven Life, this book sold in the millions. He says, "I've been at the bedside of many people at the moment of death, and I never heard anyone say before dying, 'Bring me my diplomas, my awards, my trophies, my medals, because I want to have a look at them.' But almost all of them, all of those who were on the edge of eternity, wanted in their last minutes on earth to be surrounded by their loved ones, their friends, the people who meant a lot to them." Yes, life revolves around people, not around objects. The popular actress Sophia Loren one day was sobbing very bitterly because thieves had broken into her home and stolen all her jewelry. Now you can imagine that her jewelry was of the finest kind. It was expensive jewelry. And she thought the jewelry she lost was irreplaceable, so she was weeping bitterly, she was sobbing, which is a natural reaction to loss. Her director, Vittorio, noticed this, and he approached and said, "Sophia, I am older and more experienced than you, and I want to give you this advice. Never weep over things that cannot weep over you. Never weep over things that cannot weep over you." What he meant is that people are more important than material things. Material things may disappear one day, But the friendships, the human relationships that we establish last through time and eternity. The problem with so many people is that their priorities are mixed up. I once heard a story about a prankster who broke into a department store and switched all the price tags. Cheap items were priced at in thousands of dollars, and expensive items were priced at $1 or $2. He just switched the price tags. And this is what the devil has done, and he has succeeded. He has switched the price tags on us. And unfortunately, there are millions of people in this world who value the transitory more than the eternal. There are many people who value the material over the spiritual. Some parents would spend thousands of dollars to straighten out the teeth of their child. They send him to an orthodontist, and you know the orthodontist charges are not cheap. So parents will spend thousands of dollars to straighten out the teeth of their child. That's money well spent, but they are reluctant to spend $300 for sending their child to a Christian summer youth camp. Or they'll give their child $20 to go to a show and give him $1 for his Sunday school offering. Have you noticed this discrepancy? On this Memorial Day, let's remember the things that really count. Let's remember the things that are of eternal value. When we look back at the cross of Calvary, we remember that Jesus Christ made the ultimate sacrifice for us. He died to save us. He was not compelled to do so. Jesus says, "Nobody takes my life from me. I lay it down of my own free will." Jesus willingly went to the cross, not as a victim, but as our substitute. He died in our place. He experienced the death that he did not deserve, that we might share in his eternal life one day. Some people call Memorial Day Decoration Day because they decorate the graves of veterans and their loved ones with flowers and flags. And that's very proper to do. Show respect to the memory of those whom we love. But it's better to show love and respect for the people we love when they are alive. I read about a car salesman called Mitt Root. He was a car salesman in Spokane, Washington. But he also volunteered as a youth counselor, counseling juvenile delinquents. He would, after work, visit these juvenile delinquents at a detention center and teach them lessons from the Word of God, pray with them and for them. And he was able to lead 24 of those young people to faith in Jesus Christ. Then one day, Mr. Rood had a exploratory surgery And they found that his stomach was full of cancer, so they stitched him up and sent him home. He died after a week. At his funeral, one of his friends remarked that no one mentioned how many cars he had sold, although he was a very successful and honest salesman. Nobody mentioned how many cars he had sold, but they mentioned the 24 people whom he had led to faith in Jesus Christ. In Colossians chapter 3, verses 12 and 14, the Apostle Paul says, as God's chosen people, clothe yourself with kindness, gentleness, humility, patience, and then says, bear up with each other. That means put up with one another. You know, some people are difficult to live with, but here we are told to put up with one another. And forgive. Forgive whatever grievances you might have against each other. And over all these virtues, over all the virtues of kindness, gentleness, humility, and patience, let love reign supreme, because love is the perfect bond of unity. What unites us is the love of Christ. Let's forever be mindful of this fact. And if we want to exert a positive influence, we have to love people. Love people, put up with them, forgive those who may offend you or hurt you. And be patient. I read about Maggie Smith. She was an 85-year-old widow who always read the local newspaper, and when she found somebody was in trouble or wanted to help him, when she heard that an old woman's refrigerator quit working and she didn't have enough funds to replace it, she bought a brand new refrigerator for her. When she heard that a boy had his bicycle stolen, she went and bought the best bicycle that Sears had for sale and gave it to that young man. So she was known for helping people in her community. And one day, the local newspaper editor asked her why she did those acts of kindness, and she replied, I believe in giving flowers to the living. I believe in giving flowers to the living. You know, on Memorial Day, we go and place flowers on the tombs of dead people. That may be a praiseworthy practice, but it's better to show our love and gratitude to people while they are alive. Give flowers to the living, not to the dead. A man put up a sign in his backyard advertising puppies for sale. One of those who inquired about the puppies was a young boy. So he knocked on the door and wanted to know if the puppies were still available. The man said yes, and said, how much? How much are you selling each puppy? The man said, $25. I want $25 for each puppy. Now the boy was crushed because all he had was $5. He didn't have more than $5 in his pocket, and he wanted to own a puppy. Then he said, may I have a look at those puppies? Sure. And then he noticed one of the puppies was limping. And he said to the owner, it looks like this one puppy cannot walk straight. And the owner said, yes, her leg is injured and she'll be crippled for life. And the young boy said, I want to buy that puppy. I want to buy this crippled puppy because it will need lots of care and love. And I am the only person who can give that love and care for that puppy. And he pulled up his pants and he revealed that on his right leg he had a brace. And he said, like this puppy, I too am crippled. I can't walk very well. So I can sympathize with this. I want to buy this puppy, but I don't have more than $5. Can I pay you in installments at a later date? I'll give you $5 and then we'll arrange monthly installments. Each month I'll pay you $5 until the whole price is paid. The owner of the dogs started weeping and he said, you take this puppy and don't worry about the money. In Revelation chapter 2, verses 4 and 5, the Apostle John praises the church of Ephesus because they have preserved the purity of the gospel. Their doctrines were biblical. Their faith was orthodox. There was, but they had one deficiency. Jesus says, I have one thing against you. You have one defect, one thing to straighten out. You have lost your first love. And then the risen Lord says, remember, remember from where you've fallen and repent. So Memorial Day is a remembrance day, is a day we remember. So let's also review our spiritual life and see if we have backslidden, if we have fallen away, if we have fallen by the wayside, and this is the proper time to remember and repent and then return to the Lord. I call these the three R's. Remember, repent, return. Unless these three steps are taken, the cycle is incomplete. So may the Lord bless you, and as you enjoy your Memorial Day weekend, remember to establish closer relationships with your loved ones and with your Lord.